Hey everyone! A lot of people recently purchased the Flipper Zero at DEF CON, so I thought I would make an overview video of the Flipper Zero. Hopefully by the end of the video, you'll understand some of the capabilities and how to extend it further. Be sure to check out my YouTube playlist on the Flipper Zero for more in-depth videos. Let's get started! The Flipper Zero can control a bunch of infrared devices. We'll go to Infrared, and then we'll choose Universal Remotes, and then TV. And then right now we have the power button. You could also choose a different button using your arrow keys. Press OK. And now it's going to send all the different power signals universal. And it just found my TV. And so now we can go to volume and press OK. And now it's sending all the different volume signals. And there's the volume. You can also use learn remote if you have the remote. And then just go ahead and face the other remote to it and record that. And then you can go to save remotes. And this is the remotes you've learned. And you can program what each of these button names are. So I'm going to go ahead and go into source, and you can see that we're switching our TV sources, and then I'll go to OK, and now we've select that source. So that's just easier than having to wait for all those other remotes. You can also go to debug if you have a remote, and then you can send the other remote to it. So I'll just press the 9 button and we can see the code. And a lot of times from this, you can figure out similar codes that might work with your TV that maybe aren't in the remote that you own. Next, we have bad USB. So I'll go to the SD card and then bad USB. You can see our bad USB script presses Windows R, waits a half a second, types in some YouTube URL, and then presses Enter. So we'll go ahead and drag that file to our QFlipper app, and then we'll close QFlipper. These scripts aren't magic, they just automate whatever a hacker would have typed. On our Flipper Zero, we'll choose bad USB, and then we'll load the RIC script. Make sure that we're USB cables plugged in. And then when we click the run key, we can see it runs our script. All right, Spike, see this Flipper Zero? Do you consent to me scanning your tag using the Flipper Zero if I take you to the park? Oh! Spike seems to have given his consent, so we'll go to 125 kHz RFID, extra actions, and then read ASK with the animal. Oh no, he's having second thoughts. So then next you just have to find the right spot on the dog and try to not move it around too much once you're over the right spot. If it's a newer chip, you may also see temperature information. Next, we'll just use read with an EM4100 chip. So go ahead and put that behind the Flipper. And there you go. And if we click on more, you'll see the options such as save, emulate, and write. Next, we'll go into NFC, and then we'll choose read, and we'll put an NFC tag behind the Flipper. And there's an NTag 215. You can see the UID in the pages. Here you can also do save, emulate, and info. And then next, I'll demonstrate reading an item where we don't have all the keys. So some NFC tags, you need keys to unlock all the sectors. So here it found one of the 32 keys, but it didn't find the other keys. The Flipper Zero has multiple applications to help you load in those user keys. In some cases, you can just use Detect Reader and detect the keys straight off of the reader. Next up, we have the software implementation of U2F. So let me log into my AOL account. So we'll do our username, our password, and now it's saying touch the security key. And so over on our Flipper, we have this OK to authenticate. We click OK. We wait a couple seconds to authenticate. And now we've logged in.
You've got mail.
Next, we'll go into Sub-GHz, and then we'll go to Frequency Analyzer, and then we'll press a button on our remote, 433.91, and then we'll go into Read. You can see that frequency is correct. If not, press a left button and change the frequency. So now that it's scanning, we'll go ahead and press a button on our remote. And then we can press OK button on the Flipper to see the details. And then if you watch the outlet, we can also click on the OK button from here to send a signal. Next, we'll look at a remote that the Flipper doesn't know about. So we'll go into Frequency Analyzer again, and we'll press a button on our thing. So 310 megahertz. And then this time we'll go into Read RAW instead of Read. We'll go to Configure. We'll switch that frequency down to 310 megahertz. We'll also change the RSSI threshold. Doesn't really matter what number, just kind of some value that's big enough that we're not getting a bunch of other signals. And then we'll go ahead and press a button on our remote. There's the signal. Go ahead and hit stop. And sometimes the remotes need to be further away from the flipper for a good signal. But I think in this case, it's fine. You can see here we are, and you can see the outlet's off. And I press the button, and it turned on. Next, we have iButton. So a lot of iButtons, you'll see this little circle on the back of maybe like a keychain or something. But what we're going to do here is just put it against the reader button. And then we can see that data. And if we click on the more, we can have a save or an emulate as well. When you go to emulate and say OK, then it's these two pins here that you put where the circle would normally go on the reader. Next, we have GPIO, which is General Purpose Input Output, which are these pins on the top of the flipper that allow you to connect to different electronics. So if here we'll do the 5 volts on GPIO. We'll put in this board from Make It Hacken. We turn that on, and you can see now we have the power. And so now the flipper is actually powering this circuit, and we're able to use the circuit. Next, we'll look at a different board that also supports GPIO. So this one has little lights that show you each of the pins. So we'll go into manual control, and then you'll notice that as I press OK on the different pins, the lights turn on. One thing to notice is that when you do go to all, most of these are general purpose pins, but some of them like RX and TX, you need to write extra code if you want those pins to enable. If you enjoy learning about electronics, I definitely recommend getting some GPIO boards and playing with them. The website flipc.org is an unofficial flipper app store, and you can go here and find different applications to install on your flipper. So we'll go ahead and click on that FlipperScope app. You can see that you can choose your channel depending on if you're running a release or development. Also, you can pick which firmware you want. Once you've picked the right thing, click the install and it'll install onto your Flipper Zero. A lot of these applications don't have a lot of documentation, but if you click on the author name, it'll take you to their README, which usually has a lot more information on how the application is intended to work. Okay, so this particular application, I've hooked up a wire to the pin that it recommended. So we'll go ahead and go into apps, and then this was in the GPIO category and Flipper Scope, and I'll say run. And you can see a little oscilloscope. And as I touch that wire and send different signals in, we're able to see those 60 hertz signals. So this is a great way to add new applications and features to your Flipper Zero. And then the last thing I wanted to demonstrate in this video was the mobile app. So I'll go into Flipper. In this mobile app, we can go into the hub. And then here's the official app store with different applications we can install. So we can go in. There's mass storage, and I can click on mass storage, and now it's installing that feature so my flipper can also be a USB memory stick. So it looks like that installed successfully. So over in our flipper, we'll go up to apps, and then we'll go into that USB folder. This is where we installed it, and then go down to mass storage. And there's our new application that we just installed. Thanks for watching this video. Hopefully you have some ideas of what you can do with the official firmware on your Flipper Zero. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, please leave them below or on my Discord server. Let us know which apps you find most helpful for the Flipper Zero.